venerable fellows, nuns, my dear colleagues, let me at the outset express immense thanks to India Foundation and Nalanda University for organizing this conference as well as for inviting me. And I understand that Nalanda University is, you know, under the leadership of the present Vice-Chancellor, makes new heights, because my colleague Srikala Nair told me that Vice-Chancellor is a dynamic personality who is looking after all aspects of the university. Thank you. And last 2 days, we have had enough discussions and deliberations on the various facets and dimensions of these four fundamental concepts or truths, or the highest goals of life, which have been testified and validated by time. There is no need of endorsement or authorization by anybody. What we need is to ponder over why we ourselves have distanced from these highest principles in life, or why we have distanced as a way of life and a way of thinking, we have distanced ourselves from these great ideals and teachings of these great masters. There is the fundamental issue lies. In no further interpretations, we need not. So it is in this context I am making this humble presentation, Enlightenment approached through Shantigiri text, because Shantigiri, the founder guru of Shantigiri Ashram, Navajyoti Sri Karunagara Guru, a Kalandra Guru. So this guru came and told the world certain unheard truths in spirituality, unheard. In this context, I am making this humble presentation within the time limits. So these are very general statements. In our modern life situation, where everything is materialized and humanized, is grossly relegated and neglected, the discourse on the relevance of Sat-Chit-Ananda and enlightenment in the context of our present way of life and life vision deserves sustained importance and relevance. So in no other land the science of soul has achieved such an amazing height as in India. The science of soul found its fruition in the Atmajnana tradition of India. Moksha was a living experiential spirituality in Vedic culture. The seers in this tradition, who were fully realized gurus, guided humans to the ultimate goal of life, that is moksha. How we lost the Dharma-centered mode of life and thinking, and the resultant arresting of spiritual progression leading to moksha and social evolution needs focused attention and consideration. We are at present living in a situation where paravidya has been replaced by abharavidya. So the concepts of moksha, mukti, nirvana have been fundamental to all major religions in India. So I think these are not required. So moksha is the fourth purushartha, the final goal of soul. It is the ultimate goal of the Hindu religious life. Moksha is called mukti by the yogis, nirvana by the Buddhists, and the kingdom of heaven by the Christians. I have got. So in Vedic culture, the attainment of amritam or immortality was the ultimate purpose of human life. The karma siddhanta was a lasting contribution of Hinduism, and it was developed in Mahabharata and Bhagavad Gita. So Nirvana is the, so it is how Buddha has defined it. I don't need to again elaborate upon it, because already it has been elaborately discussed. So in Nirvana Sutra, the Buddha explained Nirvana in the following ways. Everybody knows it. So So enlightenment in the revelatory spirituality of Navajodhi Sri Karunagara Guru. The revelatory spirituality of the Guru reaffirms the experiential reality of moksha, which is considered as the ultimate goal of human life by major religions. It is not discussions or more interpretations on moksha or nirvana that we need, the Guru said. But to know why, despite the best efforts and sacrificial life of past Gurus and Acharyas, the followers have been unable to pursue a righteous life leading to moksha, it has been a vexed issue over millennia. Similarly, why great souls had to leave the world before fulfilling their mission has been a riddle in spirituality, the Guru observed. It's a very important point. On the occasion of the spiritual fulfillment of the Guru in 1973, he got revealed from Brahma Prakasham the fundamental causations as to why the previous messengers of God could not fulfill their mission, and why the spiritually and materially fallen state of humanity lingers. It was revealed from Brahma Prakasham that the life mission of the Guru was to restore Yugadharma, which was erred 25 Chaturyugas back. Nowhere in no spiritual history one will find this revelatory truth. The Guru revealed that we have been unable to lead and promote a way of life in conformity with the great ideals of our religion so as to achieve the supreme goals of life, because our spirituality and religion have been grounded on the dharma of the past yugas and still continue the faith practices and worship systems of Treta and Dwapara Yuga. The Guru asserted that when we accept the dharma and karma of the present yuga of Kali, India will emerge into the Guristanam of the world. This is to be achieved through a Kalandra Guru ordained by Brahmam. The evolution of Jiva towards perfection, from its Sushma Bhava to the highest state of stateless state of Moksha or Nirvana, passing through endless birth-death cycle, has been an experiential reality in India till the third Chaturyuga of seventh Manvantara, the Guru reveals. The evolution of Jiva is governed by the cosmic design enshrined in the Manvantara time concept, revealed through Adi Guru Manu and reflected as the eternal laws of nature. According to the time concept of India, the present Yuga is Kali Yuga. The Guru reveals that Kali Yuga is the best of all the four Yugas. Moksha or Nirvana is possible only in Kali Yuga, the Guru revealed. So I don't know how many people know these things. All Jivatmas take birth in Kali for attaining Moksha through a Kalandra Guru ordained by the Brahman. Rishis, Acharyas, Devi, Devas, all are waiting to take birth in Kali to attain Moksha. A soul's eligibility for Moksha depends on Punya acquired through Karma Purtigaranam in past births. The Guru revealed and reaffirmed the dictum Kali Sudrangal and stated that this age is destined for the liberation of not only caste Sudra, but all those devoid of knowledge beyond caste hierarchy or Brahma Jnana. It is Brahma Nichayam, the will of Brahma, that Sudra would get Brahma Jnanam and power in Kali Yuga. A way of life in conformity with the Kali Yuga Dharma or the guidance of a Kalandra Guru ordained by Brahma is the path towards Moksha. The Guru explained the enlightenment or Moksha as Layanam or merging in the Brahma Prakasham. It marks the perfection and the completion of karma. Moksha is Karma Purtigaranam according to the Guru. There is no birth or death after the final merging. A soul has to transcend avasthandarangal, spiritual stages, and to traverse these under the guidance of a Purna Guru. A soul evolves through Karma Purtigaranam and atma shuddhikaranam in past births in various yugas, the gurus noted. In spiritual pursuit towards moksha, a fully realized guru is essential to steer the seeker out of the inexplicable dangers and hurdles in astral planes. The astral planes are the habitat of mighty dark forces or powerful yoga brishtas. Maran, Parivaram, Buddha said of Maran, all these. They do not permit a seeker to go beyond their stage. They want to make a rising soul subservient to them. These powers can assume any form and mislead a seeker, leading finally to the ruin of life. Almost all great seers have mentioned about these negative astral powers and the danger they pose to the seekers. That is why the guru says, without a guru, a seeker cannot attain jivan mukti. The guru observes that jnana stage begins at the seventh stage of spiritual evolution. And only when a jiva attains the seventh stage of spiritual evolution, it gets a glimpse of the evolutionary process of a jiva. And the astral planes, as well as the inexplicable intricacies and challenges on the path towards realization. Caught in the treacherous net of mighty dark forces, seldom a soul transcends further. The guru reveals, even Lord Krishna, who according to the guru was the greatest guru ever descended on earth, could not fulfill his mission by transcending the eighth stage of spiritual evolution. Therefore, moksha is attainable in Kali Yuga under the guidance of a fully realized guru ordained by the Brahman, reveals the guru. The guru reveals that only when a soul attains the 10th stage of spiritual evolution and merges in Brahman, moksha is attained. Guru proposes karma path in Kali Yuga and notes that enlightenment is through the path of karma in which the essence of four margas are synthesized. Moksha through a righteous material life is the guru's principle. Material and spiritual are not dichotomized and treated as two sides of one and the same coin of karma. This position of guru makes his teaching relevant in contemporary social context where individual is grossly involved in material pursuit. Therefore, while we have the legacy of attaining the highest spiritual stage of moksha and its rich narratives spread over in our scriptures, the magnitude of the effort and the mystery surrounded on its attainment has been little addressed. It is this unresolved and unattended issue that Navajot Sri Karunagara Guru addressed and resolved by founding a path to achieve the highest goals of life. Thank you.